the most important terms you should include in your agreement. First, you got to know the type of agreement, right? What type of agreement are you even getting into? Like, what is this? What's the difference? What is this, right? The exclusive or non-exclusive agreement, the length of the agreement, ownership and control. Who's owning what in this agreement? Who's controlling what in this agreement? Fees and royalty splits, the right to audit and accounting, notice and right to terminate. All of these things are really, really important. So when you're looking at an agreement, these are some of the main things that you want to look at and make sure that you focus in on. So the first thing we're going to talk about right now is the type of agreement. So say I come to you and I'm like, hey, man, you know, I want to go into business with you. I feel like you're a great producer. I really, really like what you got going on. And I just want to sign you. And it's just like, okay, bro, you said you want to sign me. You don't just sign something because somebody tell you they want to sign you. What type of agreement do you want to sign me to? Is it a producer? Is this just a situation where you need a license from B-Stars Marketplace? Do you need a producer agreement? Are you finna drop a project or drop a song on a major label? Is this a work for hire agreement type of thing? Is this a recording agreement? Is this a distribution agreement? Is this a publishing agreement? Is this a management agreement? So the first thing that you want to understand, right, is the different types of agreements and what type of agreement you're getting into in the first place. That's very, very key, right? Because based on the type of agreement that you're getting into in the first place, that's going to dictate the terms that come after that. So don't just say, yeah, man, sign me. Don't just say, no, we're not doing that. The first thing that we're figuring out is, what type of agreement that this is. And here are some of the main agreements that you want to look out for. We're going to talk in our next series about some of the most important agreements. So this entire section, we're going to flesh this out and go into a whole nother thing about the most important agreements you should know. But these, here they are. You know the first one, a producer license. This is basically legal proof that producer has given permission to someone to use their beat. This could be non-exclusive or exclusive. Y'all know that. A producer agreement. You get a major placement on an album. Somebody hits you up and say, hey, bro, I really like your work. I want to work with you. I want to put you on my album. I want to get that beat for my album. That's a producer agreement. A work for hire agreement. What's a work for hire agreement, Kyle? Essentially, if somebody wants to get that work, they want to buy that work from you, or they want to have that exclusively, they're saying, look, you're a work for hire here, right? This, I want to own this. You're working for me. You're transferring over your rights. You're assigning your rights over to me. So now I own this. You're working for me. You're an independent contractor. However, this is very important because depending on the type of agreement you're getting into, the work for hire thing should not be in everything. So if you're just doing a non-exclusive license and you're just licensing over your rights to someone, you shouldn't be signing nothing that says work for hire, right? If you're transferring all your ownership rights and you understand that, then work for hire is fine there. But make sure you're always looking out to determine if you see that word work for hire, because it all depends on the type of agreement. A recording agreement. Now you're a big producer. You're selling a bunch of beats on the marketplace. Everybody hitting you up. They want you to get on their things. You're getting placements. And it's getting to a point now where you finna start your own internet money. You finna be like DJ Khaled. You're finna take off. You finna drop your instrumental tape. And a record label or a distributor, whoever comes to you and say, look, I wanted to get you under an agreement as an artist slash producer, a recording contract, right? That's another type of agreement. And that particular agreement is going to have different terms than your producer license, your producer agreement, or just a simple work for hire agreement. That's important. Distribution agreement. You say, yeah, man, you know, I appreciate y'all hitting me up. Y'all really nice. Y'all great. But, man, I got this thing clicking, man. I'm on the marketplace. I already got my songs distributed with B-Stars. You know, I already got everything going, but I can't do a distribution agreement. The difference typically between, you know, a recording agreement and a distribution agreement is a distribution agreement, you're just licensing your rights to someone to distribute the music. Whereas in a recording contract, sometimes they're looking for an assignment of your rights or ownership of your rights or your masters in return for them promoting you. So that's the difference between a recording agreement and your distribution agreement. And the reason why that's important is because based on whatever type of agreement it is, you're going to have to actually go down and look at the following terms. The next thing is a publishing agreement. That's going to be different than a recording agreement or distribution agreement. Of course, we talked about music publishing. We understand that what we're looking at most times is your mechanical royalties and your performance rights. That's your publishing and your songwriting. So that's going to be different. You know, you're going to have, could even have a co-pub agreement or publishing admin agreement. So you're looking at these different things, and that's going to determine some things. The last thing is a management agreement, right? So this is completely different than a publishing agreement. This is completely different than a producer license. This is completely different than a producer agreement where you're selling those beats, or a recording agreement. So based on the fact that a management agreement is a different type of agreement, right, the terms are going to be different. And that's very, very key. So when you're looking, the first thing you're looking for, if somebody approach you about doing anything, the first thing that you're going to think about is, man, what type of agreement is this? You feel me? What type of agreement is this?